In other news, Russia orders its troops to withdraw from Ukraine's Kherson city in a major blow to its offensive. Russian Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu announced a pullout order at a televised meeting. Russia's commander in Ukraine had proposed the withdrawal as Ukraine's counteroffensive approaches. Kiev's troops have been recapturing villages in the outskirts of the city. Kherson was the first urban hub captured by Russia when it began the war in February. On to the ongoing COP27 summit in Egypt. Former U.S. Vice President Al Gore leads the launch of an initiative that tracks global greenhouse gas emissions. Al Gore presented the TRACE initiative, a coalition of climate and tech firms that uses satellite data, artificial intelligence, and other tech to track greenhouse gas emissions across the globe. United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres said the initiative helps prevent greenwashing by companies.
TRACE and its data show that because of underreporting of methane leaks, flaring, and other activities associated with oil and gas production, emissions are many times higher than previously reported. And this should be a wake-up call for governments and the financial sector, especially those that continue to invest in and underwrite fossil fuel pollution.
We are all working toward a common goal: increased transparency, collaboration, and accountability for climate action. We must work together with the best available information if we are to exit this highway to climate hell.
The Philippines needs to adopt measures to fight climate change if it wants to reach its goal of becoming a high-income economy by 2045. That's according to the Country Climate and Development Report on the Philippines by the World Bank. The report, which was presented at the COP27 summit in Egypt, warned policy and action would impose substantial economic and human costs, especially for the poor. The World Bank last month also said climate change could reduce Philippine economic growth by up to 7.6% by 2030. This, as it noted, the Philippines is the country most affected by extreme weather events.
Temperatures in the Philippines have been rising, and they are predicted to rise by another 1 to 3 degrees Celsius over the course of this century. The productivity of many agricultural crops will decline, and obviously rain-fed crops will be the most affected. Look at about 5% reduction in the yields of rice and sugarcane, but potentially as much as 20% for maize across the three main regions. What does this mean? Lower agricultural production will affect the well-being of the farmers, many of whom are poor, and because this is going to lead to higher food prices, it will affect the well-being of all Filipinos, and especially the poor who spend a greater part of their income on food.
Civil society groups from the Philippines are also in Egypt to put the country front and center of climate change negotiations. The Musungi GeoReserve Foundation is urging for more action from developed nations rather than speeches. Fisher Folk Group Pamalakaya also calling out what it describes as false climate solutions as it demands adequate support for the loss and damage caused by climate change.